The software you use to write a book is an important decision to make, as complicated software can hinder your writing process. In this video, I will be walking you through the look and feel of two of the top software I've personally used and highlight the functionality as well as the pricing of each. First up is Google Docs. Google Docs is a favorite amongst first-time writers for its ease of use. If you already have a Google account, you can use it to sign into the software, and once there, click File in the ribbon, and you can get familiar with Google Docs by mousing over the commands. Take your time reviewing what's available to you. Google Docs ticks all the basic functions. You can, of course, format your manuscript using current submission guidelines to include headers and page numbers. But more than that, you'll love knowing that Google Docs auto-saves, which means you don't run the risk of losing your manuscript. Another important feature for writers to know is your manuscript's word count, which you can find here. Google Docs also has a spell and grammar check, as well as a dictionary if you ever need help. You can insert pictures, share your document with others, and Google Doc allows for add-ons, which allows you to build upon the Google Docs software to customize your writing experience. As a Google product, you'll find that it works better while using Google Chrome as a browser. The pros of Google Docs are the fact that it's absolutely free, there are no paid versions, and you can access it from your phone, tablet, and computer. And it even has offline capability with a Chrome browser. If you're easily distracted, you can search the web from within your document, and the calendar function will keep you on task. And best of all, you can download your Google Docs files to the commonly used Microsoft Word file at the click of a button. If you're adventurous, your audience can even read along as you write. You can also name the different versions of your document. This is great if you want to revert back to an earlier version for any reason. Google also has an outline function that detects any headers, bold, or uppercase text. And another cool feature is voice typing, which allows you to dictate your book. However, a con that a lot of writers report is slow load times if you're writing a book that is more than 70,000 words. How many words is your book? Please comment below. And don't worry, I won't leave you hanging on how to use any of these functions. Check the link in my description box for my Google Docs playlist. Software number two is Microsoft Word. Microsoft Word is another favorite of writers, as many have already used the software in their jobs or school. Microsoft Word is available separately as the free version, or you can purchase the full suite of software, which provides more functionality, the ability to have more than one user, and work offline. So basically, if you're used to having the more advanced feature a software can provide, the paid version of Microsoft might be a better fit. You can also access the software on your phone, tablet, or computer. Like Google Docs, the free version of Microsoft Word ticks all the basic functions, including formatting to include headers and page numbers, autosaves, which we'll talk a little bit more about later, displays the word count, provides spell and grammar check, allows you to insert pictures, and share links to collaborate in real time. The pros of Microsoft Word are that the free version is sufficient for most writers writing a book, whereas the paid version provides way more functionality. However, the cons, at least for the Office 365 version I'm using, is that I found it to be extremely glitchy. Something as simple as hitting undo on a document I was working on last week sent me back to the original version, and the changes I made weren't saved, and I had to recreate the entire document. Overall, choosing between Word and Google Docs is a personal choice. They both offer similar features, they both have their cons, but both can help you to write your book. My recommendation is to try the free versions of each and see just how important those more advanced features are to you. If they aren't, then the free version of Google Docs should do you fine.